Hello and a very warm welcome to all of you to our daily current affairs videos. First of all, I would like to thank you for showing so much support to my videos. All of your comments, just noted all of your comments, positive, supportive, as well as critical, are duly noted. All right, so the objective here that I am giving you some factual information or some extra information or conceptual understanding in these daily current affairs videos, you know, iske kuch important objectives hain, right? This is not a school or a college examination where you have to mug up the facts. All right. Just think about the post for which you are preparing. You are preparing for RBI grade B exam. All right. So here, not only factual information is important, but what is the level of your understanding as an individual about the backdrop of the issue, about how much knowledge you have about a certain issue that you are talking about in the interview, you are writing about in a descriptive paper, or even you are solving an MCQ, you should be knowing about the backdrop of an issue, right? Why? Because the objective here is not to only make you mug up the facts, but also understand the backdrop. All right. So at least 5 to 10 minutes of extra information or contextual understanding will not harm you, but instead it will help you grow. It will help you grow in the journey of your preparation as an individual, and finally it will help you in the way you present yourself, your opinions, your facts, your personality before the person who will be taking your interview, who will be judging you. All right, you have to be politically neutral, right? So just, you know, make sure of these facts, you know, before watching the videos, right? And in any case, any kind of criticism is constructive criticism, all right? So we will keep trying our best to provide you with the best and the quality content that you want. All right, so you can check out our RBI Grade B crash course, right? If you need any help, if you need that extra push to ensure sure shot selection in both the phases, phase one and phase two, all right? So do check out our RBI Grade B course and also download our app. Download our app to get all the information and exam updates in one single app in a smartphone. All right. It will help you. Right. It will save you a lot of time. You don't have to Google search everything. It is there in the app. You need anything, it is there in the app. All right. So download it. Stay updated on our Telegram channel, the link for which is given in the description below. Right. In that Telegram channel, only the PDF of these daily current affairs and various other useful documents will be shared. All right, so if you want to follow it, please join the link. All right, so starting off with today's MCQs, we have a very first question of the day. We have how many pilgrimage sites are on board the Temple 360? All right, Temple 360 is an online portal. All right, Temple 360 ek online portal hai jo ki Ministry of Culture ne launch kiya hai. All right, so who is the Minister of Culture? Union Minister of Culture, Mr. G. Krishna Reddy. Mr. G. Krishna Reddy has launched Temple 360, an online portal for how many pilgrimage sites? All right, we will discuss more about this scheme, but first answer the question correctly. You have options 4, 7, 5, 10 or 3. What is the correct answer? Please write down the correct answer below so that we can move on to the explanation. Okay, so the correct answer here is 4. 4 pilgrimage sites currently have facility at Temple 360 online portal, have facility for e-darshan, e-prashad, right, and e-arti. What are these 4 sites? First is your Somnath temple, right? Somnath temple, you all know where is it? You should know where is Somnath temple, all right? Kashi Vishwanath. Kashi Vishwanath temple. Please don't mind my writing. Right? Kashi Vishwanath temple and Triambakeshwar and Grishneshwar temple in Maharashtra. All right. These 4 temples currently have been given access to Temple 360 portal so that the devotees can attend e-darshan. Right? The program was launched on the occasion of the Hindu New Year festival of Navratri. Alright, so the plan is to extend the e-darshan portal to 12 Jyotirlings and 4 dham. Right, 4 dham you have, Dwarka, Badrinath, right, Puri and Rameshwaram. Okay, so these are very basic general knowledge questions. You should know, you should be knowing where these Char Dham places are. All right. So this was launched. Right. So this was launched. It is a unique portal named Temple 360. Right. And through this portal, devotees can perform online darshan. Okay. We have already discussed about these temples. These are the four temples who have been given access. All right. Later on, Char Dham and Bara Jyotirlingo ko bhi access diya jayega. Okay. Moving on to the next question. We have which country has developed Solu corridor transmission line with Indian assistance. All right. So India se assistance lege kaun si country ne Solu corridor transmission line join kiya hai. Now the options are very, very interesting. Why? Because you all know, you all read current affairs, you all know ki India assists a lot of bordering nations, be it Bhutan, right, be it Nepal, be it Bangladesh, all right, with a lot of railway links, energy transmission lines and gas pipelines. Alright. Agar yahan pe Bangladesh aa jata to options ko eliminate karna aur bhi zyada mushkil hota. But now you have to eliminate between Bhutan and Nepal. Alright, because there are hydropower power plants by the Indian government in Bhutan also and Nepal also. You will be able to eliminate if you know that Solu River is in Nepal, right? You will be able to eliminate if agar koi aur corridor ya hydroelectric power plant ka naam aa jata, for example Arun, you would be able to eliminate if you knew that Arun River flows in Bengal. Alright, so now you understand the importance of having contextual knowledge behind each and every current affair question that we read, right? Having that contextual knowledge will help you eliminate the option. Alright, so why not bag on these extra marks? Alright, because if the options are close enough, what will you do? How will you eliminate if you don't have the backdrop or the contextual knowledge? So that is also very important. The correct answer obviously over here is Nepal. Okay, so recently the Prime Minister of Nepal, Shri Shrey Bahadur Deoba visited India. Alright, and he signed a number of projects with India. Alright, first of all, tell me who is the President of Nepal. The President of Nepal, Shrimati Bidya Devi Bhandari. Shrimati Bidya Devi Bhandari is the President of Nepal, and Nepal signed a range of MOUs, a range of cooperations with India. Alright, first very important option that we read here was Solu Corridor Transmission Pipeline. Alright, it was built with help of India's line of credit of rupees 200 crore. Alright, line of credit means a sum of amount that has to be released in phases. Alright, so it has to be released in phases, and it has been co-developed between India and Nepal, and the MOU has been signed by Mohan Energy. Alright, ek aur bahut important hydropower project hai. Recently I talked about it, right? That is Arun hydropower project in Nepal. Arun River is a very important river that flows in the east of Nepal, and it's funded by the government of India to develop hydropower project. Alright. So I hope it was clear. Let's have a look at the other MOUs that have been signed between India and Nepal. So first, very important is that 132 healthcare centers have been set up by India, right, with a grant of $50 million, right, and a range of other initiatives. You can have a look, right, you can have a look, a fair look. Solu corridor transmission line, 132 health facilities, RuPay cards that were launched in Nepal, right? RuPay cards that were launched in Nepal, now they can be used in 1400 point of sale machines. So that is a very, very significant step, a very, very significant step towards financial inclusion in Nepal, right? Financial inclusion, Nepalese citizens mein abhi bhi bahut kam hai. Digital transactions are also not that much. So India holds a very good opportunity to create a digital transaction and an online market in Nepal. So this is very, very important. And the Koshi corridor in Dhalkebar and Bhittamot section has also been initiated or funded by the government of India, and three substation transmission lines also got $250 million of credit. Alright, so all these projects and all these corridors that we are reading about between India and Nepal, why are they important? Why? Because Chinese infrastructure is also gaining dominance in Nepal, right? China has developed infrastructure such as railways, roadways, and even communication lines near even till the border of India, right? Till the border of Nepal and India. So just imagine, right? If China starts dominating Nepal, then it will be a greater threat to India, all right? So that is why it is very, very important for the Indian government to invest in infrastructure projects in Nepal as much as possible, all right? So a few other cooperations that have been signed between India and Nepal is India Oil Corporation and Nepal Oil Corporation has signed an MOU, all right, for supply of petroleum products. All right, so India, as you know, is the biggest petroleum refinery, right? India ke paas sabse zyada petroleum refining capacity hai, the world's largest petroleum refinery in India, that is in Jamnagar, Gujarat, right? Other than that also, there are many petroleum refineries in India, right? And India holds a lot of potential to export the refined petroleum products to Nepal. And also it is strategically very, very important for Nepal. Why? Because it is a landlocked state, right? It is a landlocked state. It does not want to depend on any one particular country, right? It wants to secure energy and other resources from China also, from India also, from Bhutan, Bangladesh, everywhere. But it does not want to depend on any particular country. But we all know that it is best for Nepal to, you know, lean towards India. Why? Because it is a democratic nation that respects sovereign boundaries, unlike China. So that is the key issue. That is why this deal is very, very crucially very important. All right, other sectors that India and Nepal will be cooperating is your rail sector. All right, so railway cooperation, cross-border rail network start kiya hai between Jayanagar and Nepal and Kurtha and Bihar. All right, so British first established narrow gauge rail sector in between Nepal and Bihar. All right, now it stopped working for some years, right, and now it is being converted to broad gauge system. All right. It is the first ever broad gauge cross-border railway line between India and Nepal. Alright, so dusra rail line system kahan pe exist karta hai between India and Nepal? It is between Raksol in Bihar and Kathmandu in Nepal. Okay, so another very important rail link between Nepal and India is Raksol and Kathmandu, Raksol which is in Bihar. Okay, so I hope it was clear. I hope the importance of this important visit is now clear to you all. All right, now we have what is the name of the portal launched by the Ministry of MOIB for facilitating applications and process of licenses, permissions, right? Licenses, permissions, and registration for the broadcaster. All right. So, ek online portal launch hua hai, jisme jitne bhi broadcasters hain, wo aake apne aap ko yahan pe register kar sakte, and that online portal is being launched by Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Now, why is this important? It is important. Sorry. It is important. Why? Because it is important in the context of Make in India. Make in India ke context mein ye important ho jata hai, right? It is important in the context of Digital India, right? And also it is important in the context of ease of doing business, right? It is important in the context of ease of doing business. Jin jin logo ko community radios khulne hai, people who want to start their own broadcasting ventures, will, you know, will be now be able to avoid human interface, right? They will now be able to get themselves registered very, very easily at Broadcast Seva, right? At Broadcast Seva portal. All right. So this Broadcast Seva portal is being launched by MOIB. Who is the minister? Who is the Minister of Information and Broadcasting? Mr. Anurag Thakur, right? Mr. Anurag Thakur is the Minister of MOIB. All right, so this is very, very significant, and later on, in the later period, it will be linked with National Single Window System. National Single Window System, ye aap jaan lijiye, why? Because we are studying about this Broadcast Seva portal, which is important for ease of doing business and also Digital India initiative. So National Single Window System, National Single Window System is an online portal for business approvals, right? It approves know your business documents. Jaise banks KYC is approve karte hain, know your customer. This NSWS provides businessmen with KYA or know your approval form, right? Where they can track their approval status, they can track their projects, and this is very, very significant for ease of doing business, all right? And this Broadcast Seva portal will gradually be linked to National Single Window System. All right. So moving on to the next question, we have how many states have identified air routes under IACS, right? IACS is an extension of Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik Regional Connectivity Scheme, which was launched in the year 2016. All right, so ICAS IACS is also an international version of Udaan scheme. All right, so who is it? Obviously, it comes under the Ministry of Civil Aviation. All right, and who is the Minister, Union Minister of Civil Aviation? Mr. Jyotiraditya Sindhya. All right, Shri Jyotiraditya Sindhya is the Minister of Civil Aviation. Right, and he is a member of Raj Sabha. All right, MP of Raj Sabha MP, Mr. Jyotiraditya Sindhya. Alright, so basically how many states have identified air routes under the scheme, right? It is asking you states. You have 3, 5, 12, 2, 4. The correct answer here is 3. Alright, so 3 states have been identified. Who are these 3 states? Let's have a quick look. Assam, Manipur and Tripura. Right, so Assam, Manipur and Tripura have been identified as under the scheme, all right? It is basic aim kya hai iska? To enhance international travel, right? Assam and Tripura, Assam, Manipur and Tripura, they are a part of Northeastern Seven Sisters state, right? They have connectivity with Bhutan, they have connectivity with Myanmar, Thailand and Southeastern nations, all right? They have connectivity also with Japan and further connectivity. All right, I hope you get what I'm saying, that it is very, very significant. Developing international airport is very, very significant for India in context of what? In the context of Look East policy, right? Look East policy ke context mein ye bahut zyada important ho jata hai. Okay. So international destinations jo hai, wo hai Bangkok, Dhaka, Kathmandu, Yangon, Hanoi. These are all very important. Chittagong also in Bangladesh. Bangkok, you know, Dhaka, Bangladesh, Kathmandu, Nepal. Right? So northeast mein, as you can see, you have a look at this map first. And let's just focus on the northeastern region. Alright? Let's focus on the northeastern region. There are only 2 international airports in the northeast. First is Guwahati, second is Imphal. All right, Guwahati International Airport is managed by Guwahati International Airport Authority Limited, and Imphal Airport is launched by Airport Authority of India. Right, and GAIL and Airport Authority of India, right, they plan to launch a new integrated terminal building, right? New integrated terminal building is being set up by GAIL and Airport Authority of India. It's the main, let me write it down for you, right? It is integrated terminal building, right? New integrated terminal building will be set up in Imphal, right? With the help of Airport Authority of India and GAIL, and its target will be to increase international passengers to 2.4 million passengers per annum. All right, there is a huge scope for connectivity in the Northeast region for international travel, especially in the Southeast state, right? And it is also very crucial and a very important soft policy measure for India's Look East policy for people to people connection. All right, so I hope it was clear. Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following statements is not true about Criminal Procedure Identification Bill? All right, so Criminal Procedure Identification Bill pehle kuch time pehle launch hua tha aur abhi Lok Sabha ne usko pass kiya. All right, now it is asking you which of the following is not true about this bill. Alright, so you have to read the question very, very carefully and focus on the words, right? If it is asking you some incorrect statement, right? Or if it is asking you an odd man out. Alright, so if you have read today's newspapers, you will easily be able to answer this question. Alright, iska correct answer kya hai? The correct answer is the bill aims to create a central repository. Right, this is wrong. Right, the bill allows taking measurement. Right, this is correct, this is correct, this is correct, right? So the correct answer here is A, right? This is the wrong answer, this is the not true. Okay, so I hope you get the approach, you have understood the answer perfectly. Now let's look into some of the key provisions. All right, some of the key provisions of the bill. Sabse pehla underlying provision is bill ka kya hai? ये कॉन्वेक्स्ट के पर्सनल मेजरमेंट्स एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन को स्टोर करने की परमिशन देता है स्टोरेज ऑफ विद द एनसीआरबी दैट इज नेशनल क्राइम रिकॉर्ड्स ब्यूरो ऑफ इंडिया. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ इट. आई विल टेल यू द बैकड्रॉप बिकॉज इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. ऑलराइट, सो बैकड्रॉप ये कहता है यार कि सेक्शन 53 ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर, राइट, Code of Criminal Procedure का section 53 provides for the medical examination of every criminal who is arrested. All right. And currently that medical examination only includes storing of the fingerprint and footprint. Right? But we all know that technology is at very, very advanced stage. Right? We have DNA technology as well. But अभी भी हमारे यहाँ DNA technology and applications will जो कि 2019 में यू नो इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ था, इट हैज स्टिल नॉट बीन पास्ड, राइट? व्हाई? बिकॉज़ देयर इज अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन राइट टू प्राइवेसी एंड द कलेक्टिंग ऑफ द डीएनए सैंपल्स, राइट? बट यू ऑल नो हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट दीज डीएनए सैंपल्स आर फॉर क्रिमिनल इन्वेस्टिगेशन. ऑलराइट, सो सेक्शन 53 को एक्सपैंड करने के लिए, उसका स्कोप और भी ज्यादा इम्प्रूव करने के लिए इस बिल को इंट्रोड्यूस किया गया है. नाउ हाउ इज द स्कोप बीइंग इम्प्रूव्ड इन दिस बिल इज दैट यहाँ पे फिंगरप्रिंट्स, पाम प्रिंट, फुटप्रिंट तो स्टोर होते ही होंगे जैसे पहले होते थे, बट नाउ इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड फोटोग्राफ्स, बायोलॉजिकल सैम्पल, आयरस एंड रिटीना. ऑलराइट, ये बिल, ये इंफॉर्मेशन, इट कैन बी स्टोर्ड विद द एनसीआरबी फॉर अप टू 75 years. Alright, it can be so stored with NCRB for up to 75 years. Alright, it proposes to record details of the person detained, but under preventive detention के अंदर अगर कोई detain होता है तो उसके records, उसके medical records को you know store करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, right? For example, a person is arrested, but he or she has no criminal background. राइट, उसको सिर्फ प्रिवेंटिव डिटेंशन के अंदर अगर अरेस्ट किया गया है, सो स्टोरिंग ऑफ देयर मेडिकल रिकॉर्ड इट्स नॉट मैंडेटरी. एंड अगर मेडिकल रिकॉर्ड्स लिए भी जाते हैं देन दे शुड बी ड्यूली डिस्ट्रॉयड विद इन 24 आवर्स आफ्टर देयर रिलीज. ऑलराइट, So this we have already covered, right? Identification of Prisoners Act 1920, ये footprints और fingerprints के लिए allow करता है, and also section 53 of Code of Criminal Procedure. All right. If a person with no, we have also discussed this. All right. So just look at this mind map. You will get an idea about what the bill really is about. And of course, we all know a bill after it is passed by the Lok Sabha, it goes to the Raj Sabha. All right. It goes to the Raj Sabha for further evaluation and criticisms and all the standing committees. Right. So it is still a bill, not an act. Just keep it in mind. Okay, so moving on to the next question, we have how many rural households have been provided with tap water supply, right? Approximate answer pooch raha hai with Jal Jeevan Mission as on April 5, 2024. Jal Jeevan Mission, you all know, have been launched by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, all right? And its main aim is to provide har ghar ko jal, right? Tap water connection to all the rural households by the year 2024, all right? So mid target mein assessment agar liya jaye to 2022 April 5 2022 mein tap water supply kitne percentage of rural households ko mila hai, the question is asking you that. All right, so the data has recently been released by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. All right, who is the Minister of Jal Shakti? Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, Shri Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, is the Minister of Jal Shakti. All right, and he has recently released a document where it states that 48% of the rural households have been provided with tap water. Now, it is very important to note, guys, jab ye scheme launch hua tha, then only 17%, right? Only 17% of the rural households were had tap water connection. Now that connection has been improved and increased to 48%. Now, this is a very, very big achievement in such a small period of time. All right. Isme aap data dekh lijiye, 19.32 crores rural households hain, jisme se 9.35 crores ko tap water supply mil gaya hai. Right. Aur projected data kya hai? Somewhat around 3.8 crores should be able to get tap water supply by the year 2022-23. All right. It is very, very important to note कि मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति जल जीवन मिशन का रूरल सेगमेंट को देख रहा है, राइट? द जल जीवन मिशन रूरल सेगमेंट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति, बट द जल जीवन मिशन अर्बन सेगमेंट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्बन एंड हाउसिंग अफेयर. ऑलराइट, सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, प्लीज नोट इट डाउन. ऑलराइट, तो जन आंदोलन फॉर जल, जल आंदोलन फॉर जल एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट वाटर सप्लाई इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट है. ऑलराइट, नाउ इट विल नॉट बी एज सिंपल एज कनेक्टिंग एवरी रूरल हाउस होल्ड टू टैप वाटर. ऑलराइट, व्हाट इट हैज टू चेक, इट हैज टू चेक हाउ मच ग्रे वाटर इज बीइंग रिड्यूस्ड. ऑलराइट, इट हैज टू चेक, राइट, हाउ इज द ग्रे वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट इज बीइंग यू नो यूटिलाइज्ड, या हाउ इफेक्टिवली इट इज वर्किंग. राइट, एग्रीकल्चर में कितना पानी वेस्ट हो रहा है. Our rural economy is primarily agricultural based, right? We grow a lot of water guzzling crops like sugar cane or rice. All right, so sustainable agriculture is also one of its underlying objectives. All right, it ensures clean quality supply of water to every rural household. All right, so it is very, very important. Please watch videos by Manish sir to learn to get a detailed insight into the scheme, right? Because our time is limited here, this is how far as we can go. But please do go to our YouTube channel and watch Manish sir's videos, right? He is discussing about these very important schemes, which can be really, really important and helpful for your RBI grade B exam. All right. So moving on to the next slide. I hope, yes, it is also very important to note before I move on to the next question, Goa, Telangana, Haryana, all these states and this United Union Territory of Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman Diu, 100% tap water supply to all the rural household have been achieved by these states and UTs. All right. So I hope you all are following. All right, sab samajh mein aa raha hai. Okay, in case you have any doubts, as always, you write it down in the comments below. So again, if you have any doubts, you have any clarifications, do write it down in the comments. All right, so we have already discussed all these 4 points, right? A clearer image will be uploaded in the updated PDF, right? You will find it in our Telegram channel, right? So moving on to the next question, we have, which state has signed an MOU with agency Franchise the Developer, all right, which is a French funding agency to bolster bilateral dialogue in the... Okay, so you have states Himachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya. Okay, so the correct answer here is Assam, right? The chief minister of Assam, Mr. Himant Biswa Sarma. Himant Biswa Sarma held a state cabinet meeting in which a range of important decisions were taken by the Assam state. All right, let's have a quick look at what these agreements were. First example, we have the first agreement we have is the MOU between Assam and Agency Franchise the Development, which is a French funding agency. It aims to bolster or foster bilateral trade dialogue in the field of environment. All right, so it is an MOU, right? Its main aim is to sustain biodiversity, conserve biodiversity in the Indo-Pacific region, right? Indo-Pacific region mein biodiversity ko sustain karna aur environment ko sustain karna is the MOU ka one of the key objective hai, right? Also, there will be knowledge sharing and experience sharing between the stakeholders involved. It is also very, very important to note what stakeholders are involved in this, right? Asia, Africa, and France, right? Asia and Africa and France are the three stakeholders of this MOU, right? And Assam, you know, it is very, very important in terms of this MOU. Char bahut important national parks and wildlife sanctuaries hai Assam mein, some of which are Manas National Park, Kaziranga National Park, Orang Wildlife Sanctuary, all right? So, and also there is one more, all right? So you should write it down in the comments below, all right? So Assam is very, very important when it comes to biodiversity, right? Eastern Himalaya ki jo biodiversity hai, uska conservation, right? Rhinoceros and tiger population in these sanctuaries and national parks is on the rise in Assam. All right, so it is very important. So, of course, other MOUs that were state cabinet decisions that were taken by Assam government were to set up 13 Adarsh Vidyalay to improve or increase the coverage of schools, right? 97 model schools. Easy issuance of caste certificates, right? So caste certificates like SC, ST and OBC that will be issued by the Assam government without requiring the NRC document, all right? Now, another important decision that was taken by the Assam government is ₹170.15 crore assistance from NABARD. Right, NABARD ka ek bahut important branch hai, that is RIDF, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. Alright, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund is a very important entity under NABARD, and under this, Assam government has taken a 170 crore of assistance for development of roads in rural districts, right, where the infrastructure is a little short. Alright, so this was some important insight into important state cabinet decisions taken by Assam. All right. Next question, in which country is India establishing an Indian economic zone? All right. So Indian economic zone, kaun si country mein India establish kar raha hai? If you have been following current affairs before also, you already know the answer by now. Why? Because this is not the first Indian economic zone that is being established by India in this country. It is the second Indian economic zone. All right. Now that Indian economic zone is being established in Bangladesh, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, capital Dhaka, currency Taka. Okay. So this Indian economic zone एक अग्रीमेंट जो साइन हुआ है, इट इज बीइंग साइंड बाय बांग्लादेश इकोनॉमिक जोन एजेंसी एंड अडानी ग्रुप लिमिटेड. ऑलराइट, राइट. फर्स्ट इंडियन इकोनॉमिक जोन इज बीइंग एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन मीरसराई, राइट. मीरसराई ओवर एन एरिया ऑफ 857 हेक्टेयर्स ऑफ लैंड. ऑलराइट, ओवर 857 हेक्टेयर्स ऑफ लैंड मीरसराई इंडियन इकोनॉमिक कॉरिडोर इज बीइंग साइंड बाय is being developed by India. All right, the first Indian economic corridor is being developed in Mongla, right. Mongla port is a very famous port in Bangladesh, and the first Indian economic zone is being developed here. All right, so this was also important, very good development between India and Bangladesh relations. Alright, you all know that India is already investing in a lot of infrastructure projects in Japan, just like in Nepal. Sorry, in Japan also, railway line, power transmission line, and a range of projects that are being developed in India, developed by India. Alright, so it is important. I hope it was well understood. All right, now also Bangladesh is the biggest trade partner of India in the entire South Asian. All right, so India or Bangladesh ka trade kitna hota hai? $10 billion. Right, a $10 billion worth of trade exists in India and Bangladesh, making it the biggest trade partner in South Asia. Bangladesh, again I'm repeating, is the biggest trade partner of India in South Asia with the trade to an extent of $10 billion. All right. The MOU currently is non-binding, but that is just a backdrop. It'll eventually, grow to become a more stronger binding agreement, right? Currently, any economic corridor that is being set up in any country, initially it is non-binding. Some conditions are held, certain meetings are held before the MOU is finally finalized, right? It is a very long process. It is a very long process because, see, it is the talks were there. The talks were there in paper since 2015, and now only it has become effect. All right, so. Was important. As per the Ministry of Commerce country's industry data, what percentage increase trade was witnessed between India and the Philippines? All right, so abhi hum logo ne padha kuch dino pehle daily current affair ke video mein that India witnessed the largest increase in merchandise export. All right, largest ever increase in merchandise export, and this information has also been released by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The Ministry of Commerce and Industry is Mr. Piyush Goyal. All right. So this is the data. You can go through it. Exports worth $417 billion. Imports were this, and this was the trade deficit. All right. This marks an 87.5% increase over the financial year 20. All right. You can see the graph over here. I have taken this from PIB. All right, March 2020 and March 2022 ke exports mein kitna zyada difference hai. It is an 87.89% jump. All right, now these data and statistics, they keep fluctuating daily, right, on a day to day basis. All right, so this is just to give you an overview. All right, moving on to the next slide, we have which of the following companies has Indian Oil Corporation collaborated to form a joint venture in green hydrogen. Okay, so green hydrogen kya hota hai? Hydrogen kaise produce hota hai? Hydrogen is produced using electrolysis of water. All right, electrolysis of water again is an electricity consuming process. Right, now that electrolysis of water can be done through coal power, it can be done through renewable energy, it can be done through natural. All right, so So electrolysis, when the electrolysis of water is done through renewable energy sources like solar and hydrogen, then the hydrogen, that is hydrogen energy, that is the end product that is produced, that hydrogen is known as green hydrogen. Okay, I hope yahan tak clear hai. Okay, now that if that hydrogen is produced using coal power, right, the electrolysis process is done through coal, it is known as brown hydrogen. All right, if that electrolysis process is done through natural gas, right, and the emissions are captured and stored, it is known as blue hydrogen, right? Now, many reports have said that by the year 2050, 12 to 16% of renewable energy concentration or renewable energy share will be that of hydrogen energy. All right, it is very, very important for India also so to develop hydrogen energy. Iske liye National Hydro Energy Mission ek roadmap set karta hai to look at the scope of the development of hydrogen energy in India. Right, so you can see the scope already. Many merchandise have already signed MOUs and explored the area of green energy or hydrogen energy. Right, and recently a merchandise in collaboration with Indian Oil have joined a venture for production of green hydrogen. All right, so the correct answer here is LNT, Renew Power. All right, so the correct answer is only A and B. Right, Larsen and Tubro, you all know, very important Indian brand. All right, Indian company. Right, Renew Power and Indian Oil Corporation have formed a joint venture in of green sector. Iska target kya hai? To produce 5 million tons of green hydrogen by the year 2030. All right, other companies that has also explored their ventures in green hydrogen are Reliance Industries, right, to set up a facility to produce green hydrogen. Adani Enterprises have also announced Adani Petrochemical, right, to venture into the. All right, so this was it for today. I hope the class was useful and fruitful to you. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your comments, both supportive and critical. All right. So have a nice day. Keep practicing, study well. Take care and bye-bye.